If you enjoy this video, please remember to subscribe if you haven't already. And if you like what you see on my channel and would like to support me on Patreon, click on the link below. After the huge success of Star Wars in 1977, studios started to hop on the Star Wars bandwagon and recreate the success with their own brand of space movie. Even TV shows were inspired in some way from the success of Star Wars. Merchandising was also something studios wanted to tap into, especially after the huge success of Star Wars. Walt Disney Studios, known for mainly doing good, clean family films, decided to enter the realm of the space opera with the 1979 film The Black Hole. Disney had high hopes for this film, which was somewhat darker than films like Star Wars. Disney had not really had a hit since The Jungle Book. The film would boast an all-star cast, complete with robots and drones. The Black Hole was under development for 4 years. John Ho was originally hired to direct, but he dropped out. Instead, they went with a younger director, Gary Nelson. Nelson was known for his work on the fantasy family comedy Freaky Friday in 1976, which was a Disney production. $40 million was given for this lavish production, which was supposed to be Disney's most expensive production ever. The original title of the script was Space Probe 1, a title which director Nelson hated. He agreed to direct after he saw the amazing sketches and concept art for the film, which Gary Nelson thought were magnificent and highly imaginative. Science fiction author Alan Dean Foster, who did the novelization for The Black Hole, was so appalled by the bad script and added a few ideas, which he thought would improve the script and the story. A meeting by studio heads and executives was called to work out what they should do with their planned Disney epic. They came up with the idea to add big name actors to the project. Jennifer O'Neill was originally going to be cast as the lead actress, as Dr. Kate McCrae, but they went with classic actress, the beautiful Yvette Mermot, who was widely known for her role of Weena in The Time Machine in 1959. Mermot was given a short curly hairstyle, which the producers thought was more practical in zero gravity than long hair, which would go everywhere and would be almost impossible to deal with during filming. A number of well-known actors, including Peter Cushing, Donald Pleasance, and Christopher Lee, were considered for the role of the evil genius. Eventually, they cast actor Maximilian Schell, who would be perfect in the role. Roddy McDowall would voice the robot Vincent, while actor Slim Pickens would voice the dumpy-looking robot Bob. Both actors were uncredited in their roles. Veterans including Anthony Perkins, Ernest Borgnine would co-star. Cult actor Robert Forster would play Captain Dan Holland. Relative newcomer Joseph Bottoms played First Officer Charlie Pizer. But the most popular character in the movie was the evil robot Maximilian, who is one of the coolest robots in cinema. For the special effects, the studio originally wanted to rent the Dijkstra Flex camera system from Industrial Light and Magic, which was a camera used for Star Wars in 1977. This particular camera was too expensive to rent, so Disney invented their own camera called ACES. This stood for Automated Camera Effects System. The matte scan system enabled the camera to move on a matte painting, which was groundbreaking and had never been done before. The Black Hole was the last big special effects film made under the old studio system. All of these elaborate special effects were all filmed within the Disney studios without any outside help from other effects companies. The effects were so crucial that it brought veteran matte artist Peter Ellenshaw out of a 10-year retirement. The film contained over 500 visual effects shots and over 150 matte paintings were used. The space cruiser Cygnus was a 12-foot model weighing 175 pounds. The helmets of the robot Sentinels had a very limited vision. It was very difficult to coordinate, especially while they were firing their lasers. The robot named Vincent originally was to have more elaborate electronic eyes, which would have given him a greater range of movement, but the effect was abandoned. The laser guns, which originally had light-up tips, which activated when the actors pressed the trigger, this would give the animators cues when to add laser effects. However, this would prove a problem because the actors would always press the triggers when they were not supposed to. Director Gary Nelson was not satisfied with the look of the robot, Bob. Nelson thought the robot did not look battered enough and proceeded to hit the clay model continuously with a baseball bat. They then built a robot based on the battered model. The robot sentry costumes were later reused for the test reel for the film Tron. The black hole was primarily aimed for adults. To draw in the kids, the two robot characters, Vincent and Bob, who were loosely modeled after the character R2-D2 from Star Wars, and obviously the two clunky robots, were also used to sell merchandise. Unfortunately, the merchandise did not sell well when the film was released. The toys, especially the action figures, are today worth quite a bit of money and are highly sought after by collectors. Reinhard's ship was originally called the Centaurus, but was renamed Cygnus, where the first known black hole was discovered in 1964. The grid sequence that appears during the opening title of the black hole was the longest running computer sequence that had ever appeared in film. During post-production, most of the actors' dialogue was redubbed. For the soundtrack, it was one of the only times that an overture was composed for a space movie. The only other space movie that had an opening overture was Star Trek The Motion Picture that same year, which was composed by Jerry Goldsmith. The score for The Black Hole was composed and conducted by the legendary John Barry. The score is one of the most unique scores of its time and was the first digitally recorded soundtrack. The overture is usually cut when the film is shown on TV, but the overture was kept in on the DVD release. At the end of production, Disney promoted The Black Hole on its Disney Sunday TV program, The Wonderful World of Disney, on an episode called Major Effects, which aired December the 16th, 1979. The light-hearted semi-documentary featured black hole star Joseph Bottoms playing the character Major Effects. The Black Hole was the first film by Disney Studios to be given a PG rating. The trailer for the film gave away a major spoiler, showing Anthony Perkins' character being killed by Maximilian. Trailers today for films seem to have a habit of giving away major spoilers. You could say The Black Hole was the first film to do so. There were many things wrong with the effects, and in one scene, you can easily see the strings moving the robot, Maximilian, during a scene where the main characters are in the dining area, just after Reinhard leaves the room. The film runs in reverse. In an exterior shot of the room, you can clearly see Captain Holland walk backwards around the room and sit down. The record release of The Black Hole featured dialogue not featured in the film. At this time, it was a common feature to release an LP of a film featuring dialogue, score and sound effects with narration, taking the listener from scene to scene. In the official read-along recording of the film, the crew of the Palomino safely make it through the black hole. The Cygnus is destroyed and crushed like an eggshell. In the dialogue, Captain Holland says, "We've been trained to find new worlds. Let's go find one for ourselves." The kids' line of Golden Books released a book titled The Black Hole, A Spaceship Adventure for Robots. The story involved Vincent and Bob exploring the Cygnus and escaping detection by Maximilian. Whitman Comics released a comic book adaptation of The Black Hole, which was published in two parts as the first two issues of an ongoing series of comics. The fourth issue was titled Beyond the Black Hole, continuing the adventures of the surviving crew of the USS Palomino after the events of the film. But the comic book was cancelled before the stories came to a resolution. The Black Hole was released in time for the Christmas season and was released after the summer blockbusters Star Trek The Motion Picture and Alien in 1979. Reviews for The Black Hole were mixed. Hollywood Reporter film critic Arthur Knight said, "Despite a title that appears to be both sexist and racist, The Black Hole is far from controversial. This about a family adventure set in deep space." Famed critic Roger Ebert gave the film 2 stars out of 4, stating, "It takes us all the way to the rim of space, only to bog us down in a talky melodrama about mad scientists and haunted houses." Time magazine and Variety actually praised the film. One critic called the film a silly concoction, where the story disappears down a black hole. Although the film made its money at the box office, the film was a major disappointment when it came to plot and story. However, the film has garnered a cult following since then. I actually liked The Black Hole. It was something totally different for a science fiction movie. It was a more darker film, especially with the character Reinhardt. The film was originally aimed at adults, and you can see this because the film has adult themes, and sometimes the film can feel rather bleak and horrific, especially with the death scenes of some of the characters in the film. Partway through the film, it takes a weird turn and becomes a kid-friendly film, especially with the robot characters Bob and Vincent. It feels out of place in a mostly dark film. Plot and dialogue is poorly executed by the actors, which is a shame because the film has a brilliant cast. Their acting comes off as very wooden and hammy, and the villain played by Maximilian Schell is just your standard cliche villain with no real depth, which is disappointing. The Black Hole had so many possibilities. When thinking about the plot and story, the movie Event Horizon comes to mind. Obviously, they were inspired in some way by The Black Hole because the plot is very similar. The ending of the film is very bizarre and doesn't make much sense. I'm sure fans of this film have many theories about the ending. Disney were trying something new and fresh, and I commend them for that, but it was poorly executed. This is certainly a film that should be remade and reworked by a good director. I'm thinking Christopher Nolan to direct. I'm sure there have been talks to remake the film. The Black Hole is certainly an eye-catching film and must have looked amazing on the big screen, especially in 1979. The film does have its merits and great qualities. I love the idea of the film. My name's Jonathan. Thanks for watching, and please subscribe if you haven't already.